my MCX Masters kit. Just two rack toms, two floor toms with pinstripes all across, 10, 12, 14, 16.
Sounded awesome after we got it all tuned up and, you know, spent a half day picking the right symbols.
My secret China that no one needs to know is a PSD5.
Right mics on the cymbals, just the way you're supposed to make a record. You know, as far as tech on guitar stuff, we went real amps, the way, you know, the way I think it's cool. Not that I have anything against the simulators out there, but plug the guitar into a PV6505, put it on a Marshall 412, and went, holy shit, that's awesome.
Last album we used two heads through two cabinets using three mics total. This time we used just the 6505 through one Marshall cab.
Mic'd it up with some pretty standard mics.
And then a SM58 with the top part screwed off and an AKG414. We used this Carbon Ultra V for literally the entire album. It's a maple neck with two walnut stripes, wings are alder. Neck through Floyd Rose.
Ran them through some neat preamps, and it was pretty cool. It was very, very simple, and it worked. Bass, you know, pulled out a trusty Fender.
The bass on Virus of the Mind was recorded through this mid-70s Japanese-made Marcus Miller Fender jazz bass.
And, you know, we did some reamping through some Marshalls and stuff, which added some cool grit to the bass tone.
And we just took this and went straight into a 1904 Marshall JMP that's like diesel powered or something, I don't know, but it just sounds good. It's raunchy, it's punchy.
Cutting vocals, you know, SM7, Neve, 1176 compressor, and then Parker. Killing it.